The Honourable Minister of Information, my colleagues at NADC, gentlemen of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. The Petroleum Technology Development Fund, taking a cue from Mr. President's transformation agenda, which has the key objective of changing the way things are done and to reinvigorate the critical sectors of the economy towards a sustainable path, we at the PTDF, under the guidance of the Honorable Minister of Petroleum Resources, are carrying out far-reaching activities in the reform of the oil and gas sector. Our role principally is to build capacity of Nigerian workers in the oil industry with all its ramifications. Mr. Chairman, a mandate therefore is for the training and education of indigenous manpower in the oil and gas industry. For us to achieve the mandate of the fund in the area of capacity building, several projects and programs were carried out within the period under review. This can be broadly categorized into human capacity building and institutional upgrade. I will take the human capacity building first. Again, the thrust of our human capacity building is to develop indigenous manpower. And in doing this, we have two key programs, the Overseas Scholarship Scheme and the Local Scholarship Scheme. Under the Overseas Scholarship Scheme, our emphasis is mostly on our students to obtain Masters of Science degrees in several areas related to the oil industry. We also have several doctoral students also trying to attain this. In the period under review, 761 scholars have graduated with Master of Science degrees and 116 with doctoral degrees. 341 master's degree scholars will complete the program at the end of the year 2013, and 287 PhDs in the next 2 years. In order for us to concentrate on the key areas of training, we consult with the key stakeholders in the industry to identify the skills gap. And in identifying the skills gap, our emphasis will continue changing from year to year. You will observe from the pie chart that engineering is mostly emphasized now, with about 46% of the total number of students that are engaged in several studies. The environment and management are also very crucial, and we have about 38% of our students in this. The information sector is also very critical, same thing with the sciences. The pie chart aptly illustrates that. in order for us to be able to get more students into the master's and doctoral programs, what we did was to disengage the UK-based consultant that we had, who was managing our scholars, as a result of which we have made substantial savings. These savings we have plowed into taking in more master's and doctoral students into the program. Access to the program by more Nigerians. What we have done also is to introduce online payment for application using ATM cards and having PIN numbers. From this, we have had an increase of from about 2,500 students applying to over 13,000. This has assisted us in no small way to eliminate document displacement and has tremendously reduced the cost for us. The next slide shows, we also have a local scholarship scheme, and we have about 17 universities taking part in this. We have awarded 351 local scholarships to our students. The next slide indicates the various universities that are involved in this program, the number of students in the institutions, and the years. You'll say just between 2011 and 2012. We also have the what we call the University Lecturer Skill Enhancement Training Program, or STEP. This program enhances efficiency of the lecturer's research and teaching skills and techniques. It also enhances the employment of the graduates, of our graduates in the oil and gas industry. To reach more lecturers, we will be domesticating part of the program in Nigeria. The industry being our base, the oil industry being our base, we have industry-specific trainings. And what we have done in industry-specific trainings, we have trained about 202 and 259 industry personnel at overseas and locally, respectively. Security remains a key challenge in the oil sector. And we have also focused on this and have trained about 32 security men on how to secure oil and gas installations. We have a vocational training program, which we call the Enhancement Training and Learning Program. About 300 participants, mostly teachers, have attended the program in the country. In the oil industry, welding is very critical. So we must develop the skills for us to get our indigenous manpower into the IOCs. And what we have done is to train people in pipe welding, tube welding, and plate welding, specifically for the oil industry. 500 personnel have been trained in plate welding. And for you to be able to work in the industry, you have to be internationally certified. Our students are internationally certified through the International Institute of Welding. The same goes for what we call fillet welding. We have trained 700 personnel, and they are also internationally certified. The module B of plate weld and pipe weld we expect to be completed at the end of 2013. Also, we take a lot of training in what we call underwater welding because of offshore facilities that we have. And we have 11 Nigerians trained in this, and they are also internationally certified by the renowned Underwater Welding Institute in Marseille, France. Drilling also remains a core aspect of the oil industry. We have trained 15 Nigerians at the French Institute of Petroleum in France. And they are also internationally certified, so they can work anywhere within the industry. And 9 of our trainees are also undergoing post-training attachment with the NPDC and the NNPC in Benin, Edo State. In order for us to continue to train our lecturers in software, we have what we call the Open Tech Setting International Interpretation Software Training. This is specifically for lecturers, for them to be able to do a lot of interpretation. And we have done, trained 138 lecturers from 9 institutions on the use of geosciences software across the country. We also have the post amnesty capacity building program. We have 50 youths who are undergoing 3 years Bachelor of Science degree in oil and gas related programs in a university in Malaysia. Again, post amnesty vocational skills training program. These are also components of the oil industry. And we have about 120 students who were training in Cotonou, or who were training in Cotonou. Out of these, 97 of them have graduated in May 2013, and 23 are still undergoing the training. It may also be asked, why are we going to end surveillance? The oil industry remains critical to the economy of Nigeria. And in doing that, we have 20 students undergoing private pilot license and commercial pilot license training in South Africa. And they are to acquire specialized skills in air surveillance security for the purposes of mining security and gas platforms and pipelines. The Niger Delta Ministry earlier had approached us towards the training of some of their youths, and we have trained 216 of their youths in arbitration, mediation, and dispute resolution through the establishment of clubs in 54 secondary and tertiary institutions in the Niger Delta. We also are partnering with the United Nations Institute for Training and Research. It's a specialized training, and we have counterpart funding from UNITA, that's the Institute for Training and Research, to train 60 Nigerian youths at the Bachelor of Science degree level in Norway for seafaring, maritime security, and subsea engineering. China is a wave of the world now, and all other countries are looking towards China. Things seem to be shifting to the east. The Nigerian government intends taking full advantage of this, and we are doing that already. And what we have done, because the Chinese are driving the world economy now, and also in technological terms. So we want to tap into that knowledge, and we have 70 Nigerian youths who have commenced training in Wadong University of Petrochemical Technology and Guangzhou City Construction College of Petroleum Engineering in China. These are some pictures at the institute. The top one shows a mini refinery within the school where the students are taught the procedures of processes of refining petroleum products. Still with the part of systemic control of capacity building within the industry, we also deal with a lot of research and give some grants on an annual basis to researchers. In 2011, we had some breakthroughs from some of the people doing some research for us that are relevant to the oil and gas industry. Some of these breakthrough results from the period under review are as follows: software application in wellbore for management of reservoir optimization, synthetic development of locally sourced bentonite as additive in drilling mud, and then synthetic development of fuel briquette from water hyacinths and cow dung mixture. The year 2012 to 2013, we also have given out grants to 5 researchers, and they are working on the following: immobilized oil degrading microorganisms in local cellulosic materials for rapid deployment in bioremediation of petroleum contaminated soils. The other, hydrocarbon source rock evaluation in the Cretaceous to Neogene basins of southern Nigeria and implication for Niger Delta petroleum systems. We also have the development of bentonite minerals as drilling mud in the petroleum industry. The development of novel technology for diagnosing and remediating problems associated with oil fields, reservoir soaring, and corrosion in the petroleum industry. And also the development of biofuel technology from locally sourced cellulosic materials. These are all specific to the industry. We also have for us to develop the institutions and still continue a lot of research. We have endowment programs with 6 universities, and in that project we have 6 functional chairs of endowment. And we've also had some breakthroughs in this, and I will list them. One is the development of zeolite white catalyst using novel techniques, the development of biodiesel from non-edible oil seeds using novel technology, and they have also designed, fabricated, and commissioned a gas dehydrator for teaching and learning. For the young minds to develop interest and to encourage them in the study of science subjects as a basis for advances in technology. The winners of our 2011 edition are currently benefiting from our local scholarship scheme. These are some of them that we have shown. Next slide, please. Mr. Chairman, in summary, within the period under review, We have trained over 3,233 trainees and scholars who have completed various human capacity training programs. 1,646 are currently ongoing, and we have about 60 about to commence in the next couple of weeks. Mr. Chairman, earlier I said I will be speaking mostly on human capacity building and institutional development. Our institutional development activities are geared towards developing infrastructure within the universities and some federal, other federal government institutions that take up that have things to do with the oil industry. These projects are spread across the country and is to provide quality indigenous capacity for all the oil and gas industry. The upgrade comprises the construction of buildings for departments related to the oil and gas, the provision of books, the provision of buildings for ICT centers, and the provision of computers and other necessary peripherals for them. Also, within the universities, we give laboratory equipment and upgrade the equipment within the departments. Most important of all, also, journals are very important for researchers and students to keep abreast of what is happening across the world. So our emphasis is also on journals for the various institutions that we are involved in. We have six universities under the phase three upgrade projects, which we have already completed, bringing the total number that we have worked with to 22. And four are various stages of completion. These are some of the universities: University of Maiduguri, we are working with the Geology Department; University of Ibadan, we are working with the Petroleum Engineering Department; University of Nigeria and Sota, we are working with the Geology Department; University of Benin, the Chemical Engineering Department; Manubelu University Zaria, the Chemical Engineering Department. Even though we intend linking the Geology Department with the Chemical Engineering Department, with what they agree. Then the Usman Dafodio University, the Petroleum Chemistry Department, University of Jos, Geology and Mining, and University of Port Harcourt for Gas Engineering Department. In Bayero University, it's Electrical Engineering Department. University of Uyo, the Chemical and Petroleum Engineering Department. Abubakar Tafawa Balewa University, Bauchi, Petroleum Engineering Department. University of Ilorin, Geology and Mineral Sciences Department. University of Calabar, Applied Chemistry Department. Obafemi Awolowo University, Ife, Geology Department. The Federal University of Technology, MENA, the Chemical Engineering Department. The Federal University of Technology in Owerri, the Petroleum Engineering Department. We have also completed several projects, such as the ones in the University of Lagos, with the Chemical Engineering Department, the Enugu State University of Science and Tech. We're working with the Metallurgical Materials Engineering Department, the Benue State University, the Chemistry Department, Umaru Musa Yaragua University in Katsina, the Renewable Energy Center, the Nigerian Defense Academy, which is also a university institution. We're working with the Mechanical Engineering Department, and the Federal University of Technology, UNA. We're also working with the Mechanical Engineering Department. We still have some ongoing projects within this space, and these are the University of Abuja. We're working with the Physics Department, Nnamdi Azikiwe University in Awka, the Mechanical and Production Engineering Department, the River State University of Science and Tech, the Chemical and Petrochemical Engineering Department, and also the Niger Delta University at Wilberforce Island, the Mechanical Engineering Department. These are some of the pictorials on what we have done. This is the University of Lagos, the departmental building. These are some of them. The University of Calabar, Uyo, Ilorin, etc. Also, the font, in order to make effective what we have been doing by training a lot of our students outside the country to acquire knowledge, we must also, apart from the industry, find a place to keep them and bring the knowledge they have gained overseas and try to provide the same environment, the same academic environment they have enjoyed overseas in terms of equipment and all that. In trying to achieve this is why we are setting up several institutions to help us carry this through so that they become full-fledged institutions that can internationally compete. We are fully involved with the establishment of the Federal Polytechnic in Ekore. The construction has progressed tremendously from 45% to 90% completion within this period. This is an area view of the university. We are going to push very well in the next couple of months to get it fully completed and get Mr. President to come and commission it. These are some of the works that have been done at the Federal Polytechnic Ekore this morning. Also, we are fully involved with the Federal Polytechnic in Bonny. We all know that the LNG is situated in Bonny, and our intention is to provide technical manpower to the LNG. So, the Federal Polytechnic in Bonny will be mostly associated with training in gas. We are at about 54% completion stage, and within the next 1 year or so, we'll push very hard to get it completed so that we can service the industry it was meant for. There is also, in making policies and having strategies, we are fully involved with the National Institute of Petroleum Policy and Strategy, which is our institution in Kaduna. We are building that specifically for policy and strategy for the oil industry. And it will be an international center which will attract a lot of brains to come in and do a lot of things for us. It's at about 72 completion stage. We will push gradually for the completion of the institute and bring it to use. So these are some of the projects within the institution, the pictorials. Next slide, please. Again, the Petroleum Training Institute in Efuru, it's an educational and organization upgrade which we have completed. We're also fully involved with the infrastructural development of the institute, and we are at about the 87% completion stage. Again, we will push in the next 1 year to get this done as quickly as possible so that it can be fully put in use. These are some of it, the laboratory block, the training center block, and our emphasis also is on hands-on experience. So we have a coiled tubing simulator and a well-test surface equipment simulator. the web. Also, to develop skills within the sector, we'll be training a lot of middle-level manpower, and we have thus set up a skills development and training center in Port Harcourt. Again, this project commenced in 2011, and it's at about 71% completion stage, and we will push to get it completed as soon as possible. These are some of the buildings under construction. Again, we talked about ICT being very critical because we are in an information age. So what we have done is to provide students access to ICT for enhanced learning and research. The fund has built 146 ICT centers in universities, federal colleges of education, and unity schools across the country under this one program. 75% of this have been equipped. In the phase two project, which are located in 67 schools, 5% of them have been completed and equipped. And in the next couple of months, we will select a couple of them for commission. It's not possible to go around and commission every one of them, so we'll just do a few of them. Again, this will help our youths to get into the information aid. And these are some of the buildings there. Let me say that the rapid development and modernization of the Nigerian economy, especially from 1973, has been greatly influenced by oil production. And for us not to forget the source of this wealth, we are establishing an oil and gas museum and research center in Oluwole as a permanent feature of the museum. The process of the contract award is currently ongoing. We must not forget the source. In conclusion, Mr. Chairman, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the PTDF under the current administration of Mr. President is poised and invigorated to pursue and sustain its human and institutional capacity building programs and projects in line with the transformation agenda of the administration. The fund will align its programs and projects with the laudable initiatives of the Honorable Minister of Petroleum Resources in her effort to reform the oil and gas industry and position it to effectively deliver on its mandate as emphasized by the transformation agenda. Mr. Chairman, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.
We thank the Executive Secretary, PTDF, and his team for providing capital development to our students and to the institutions in our country. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, let us once more put our hands together for the Executive Secretary and members of the state.